Gentles, perchance you wonder at this show, but wonder on till truth make all things plain.
It kind of goes up and down a little bit. My initial role, obviously, was to ask the permission of the Balanchine, of the George Balanchine Trust, and to kind of get their buy-in into this idea of mine. And then I chose the two artists, Michele Oka Doner, and I wanted her to design the sets and costumes for the production. And the reason I chose Michele is because I felt that her work, there is a lyricism to her work, there is an organic feel to her work. It almost dances in many ways. The shapes are round, they're soft, they're curvaceous, and it reminded me a lot of Midsummer's itself and actually choreography itself.
I hope that by working on the sets and costumes and working with Tarell and Lourdes, that I'll come out with the true meaning of A Midsummer Night's Dream. What I thought it was, I've let go of. And I've now entered that wonderful realm of let me see. So I'm the audience of my own invention at this point.
Tarell could work with Michele and really sit with her and figure out where you can put Midsummer's that would really work based on the production. He has this extraordinary gift of being able to take a step that you see in Midsummer's and connect it directly to the text that you read in Midsummer's. And the ability to do that and to articulate that to a dancer is extraordinary information to have as an artist. It's going to bring another level of understanding.
My role in this reimagining of Midsummer is to check in with the classics, check in with how the piece was formed from its original text, see how that structure works dramaturgically in a dramatic way. So my job is to help everyone keep coming back to the table with a singular idea.
Miami today still has the elements that seduced me as a child. The beautiful light, which is so unique. It's a mirage. All that glass, all the reflections of clouds moving on the glass, all the reflections of light on water, it's an illusion.
Well, the significance of Balanchine's interpretation, his reimagining of Midsummer's, is profound. It's pretty intimate and pretty specific. And I think using it as a starting point and staying point, none of the choreography will be changed. I mean, it is. The steps were created by George Balanchine and will be by George Balanchine. And finding a way for us, as the artists coming to this work, to find a frame that further lifts that work is a challenge. It's one of those moments where you want to take a piece of art that is beautiful, like the Mona Lisa or the Scream, and make sure that its frame doesn't take away from, but highlights what's inside of it. And so when we begin to talk about or find a frame for that, we're going to say, okay, well, what's unique to Miami in terms of the wild? What's unique to Miami in terms of that passion, that sensualness, but also that feels like it can get carried away? Well, what brings hurricanes? What brings floods? What brings also romantic evenings? The ocean. And so that's our forest. That's the unknown territory we go to that feels wild and adventurous. And I think it's gonna be really interesting fascinating and beautiful to see that reimagined.
Even just setting it in Miami is a declaration of we're doing something new. And setting it underwater, we're doing something that's not been done either. And translating the notion of we're so land struck, but all that water has so many things. The notion that we inhabit that also. We eat from it, we swim in it, we go over it to get places, we use it as a roadway. So now we're going to use it as a place that we inhabit. We're gonna be the sirens and the mermaids and who knows what else. I think the Midsummer project for Miami City Ballet's 30th anniversary is a wonderful choice. Lourdes had danced with George Balanchine in that ballet. I believe she was a hound. And it was Lourdes' idea to change the hounds into seahorses, which would be very fantastic.
I wanted something special for Miami City Ballet's 30th anniversary. I've always wanted to find a way to move the art form forward. I've always wanted to find a way to present another side to it, to show people that you don't have to know anything about ballet to enjoy it. You can come in, sit, and watch, and whatever it reveals to you is what it reveals to you. There's no right or wrong. This project is a very, very personal, it comes from the heart, and I'm about to cry because Mr. Balanchine was just such a great part of my life. He shaped it. He shaped me as a dancer. He shaped how I look at it. And so this is, it comes from a very emotional part of myself to be able to take his work and present it in a different way that I feel like I'm showing an audience. It's gonna last. It's here for a really, really long time. You guys have to let it speak to you.
So, good night unto you all. Give me your hands, if we be friends, and Robin shall restore amends.